human dies. For example, a human dies with a little smile on his face. Another dies because of an accident. What does it say about his life? The other one who burned, like my father's, by accident. And can we say he has lead a bad life? Because it was his own fault.
It was his own fault that the fire happened.
Yes, yes.
See, if somebody has to smile at the moment of death, definitely that human being has lived a very relaxed life. When death comes, if he can smile and go, definitely this person has a little more control over the whole process of life, isn't it? Isn't it so? Now death is coming to you, this moment you are leaving. If this moment you can leave with a smile on your face, because most people cannot smile in their lifetime. Isn't it? Yes? People cannot spring. They're walking outside, it's springtime, but you don't see a smile on their face. Everything in nature is smiling at them, but they are. So, can these people smile at the moment of death? No chance, isn't it? If someone has to smile at the moment of death, definitely he has a little more control, a little more mastery over life situations, isn't it? Somebody dying in an accident may not say anything about the way he has lived. No. I might have lived a wonderful life, but today I am driving and I am doing 100 mph. And just one mistake, just one mistake, it can finish my life off, isn't it? Isn't it so? So that's got nothing to do with how I have lived my life. It's just one stupid mistake in driving process can take away life. Now when you're getting burnt in a car or in an office or wherever, sitting quietly, smiling and dying is very difficult. Because your body is still fully healthy, it doesn't die easy. Now it's burning, so the burning has to kill you. But now, for somebody else, life is ebbing away for some other reason, either simply old age or whatever. The life energies have lost their vibrance. Now it leaves easily. There's no tearing. Between you and your body, there is a certain bondage. If your life energies are right now very vibrant and there, it won't leave the body easily. Slowly, as time passes, as the allotted karma dissipates, then your life energies become dissipated. When they have lost their vibrance, it will slip out of the body so much more easily. So at that time, it is a much better opportunity for a person to die with a smile on his face. Because tearing of you and the body is very easy because it's become ripe. When it's not ripe, if you tear it in an artificial way, forceful way, now, smiling and going is difficult, but not impossible, still possible. Now, suppose I crash my car and I'm dying, everything is broken in the body, and now I think, oh my God, after all this life, I have to crash my car like this and laugh and die. Possible. I would. If I die like that, you will see. In a crashed-up car, you would still find me with a smile. Because I would just look at the irony of it. How much mad driving I have done. Today, oh my God, I had to crash my car like this. like, let's say, a great race champion just taking the car out of the parking lot, he crashed and he's dying. Maybe keep him out. You know? Oh my god, after all the racing, here I am, pulling the car out of the parking lot and getting dead. Possible. But it means a certain balance. But generally, when your life is vibrant, to tear it out of your body means there is violence in it, there is pain in it, there is suffering in it. So at that time, smiling becomes difficult. Smiling or not smiling is not the issue. It is just that with how much awareness you are living, that's the issue. Only if you are aware, you can smile, isn't it? If you are caught up in a situation, you cannot smile. The people on the street, especially in Europe, they are not smiling, not because something has gone wrong with their lives. They are not smiling because they are so badly caught up with whatever their nonsense. When they are so caught up, even if they are living a princely life, still they cannot smile because they are caught up with their life. Not because life is bad, isn't it? Not because they have not eaten, they are not smiling. They are not smiling because they are entangled with their life. Everything may be happening properly, but they are so entangled they cannot smile. So it is the entanglement. You will be able to smile at the time of your death or not smile simply shows the level of entanglement with life. Anyway, you are going to die. Better laugh at it and die, isn't it? People who are initiated by me, they must smile and die. They must smile and live.